Hello everyone. Welcome to the Cebas Insights interview. For this interview, we have Paul Parneix, VFX Supervisor at Unit Image. Unit Image is a Paris-based high-end animation studio specialized in full CGI and visual effects in commercials and the game industry. Hi Paul, could we start with some background about your biology and physics and transition to the FX industry?
Yeah, of course. I actually, after my A-level, I started to go to the biology university, and I spent 2 years there, and after that I realized that I had to try to do my dream job, and I moved to Paris to become a VFX artist. So I did a school in Paris, and I graduated from the school, and then I started to work, and now I'm working as a VFX supervisor at Unit Image. And before that, I've been working for 2 years as a VFX artist at Unit Image. When I was young, I always wanted to be VFX artist. I remember I was watching Star Wars and Lord of the Rings breakdowns again and again. But for me, when I was young, it seemed to be like impossible to do. You know, it was not a real job. So I still love science, and that's why I decided to go to the science university. But after a few years, I realized that I really had to try to do. To do VFX.
Next, Paul, I'm going to ask you about how you trained to become a VFX artist in France, and how did you learn about thinking particles?
Yeah, actually, the school I did, I had a Maya formation. It was only Maya courses, so I learned LMTP in production when I started to work at Unit Image, and there was this guy called Omar Miradi, which is one of the best VFX artists I know, and he just showed me TP, and I was really impressed by the power of it, and how fast you can do things within TP, and from this day I worked in the beginning to learn TP, but you know when you there is something like a gap. If you understand the logic behind it, after that everything is so easy with TP.
Yes.
Yeah.
Awesome, Paul. So next, our viewers would like to know how you manage TP logic, of course, and did you find TP logic a challenge, or was it a breeze due to your coding background? How did you learn TP logic?
Since I came from with a Maya particle background, and if some guys know Maya particles, it's just like you do everything with expressions, and it's not really user friendly. So since I knew Maya particles before, TP seems quite seems not that difficult for me. But the logic can be a bit disturbing first, of course. But in working in dynamic simulation in particles, I realized that most of the time the logic is just the same. You feed particle with data, and the software is just a tool. And I can guarantee for if there are some new users that want to learn TP, there are plenty of resources available on the web, and it's not that hard to learn compared to other software capable of the same things.
Paul, could you elaborate on how you conceptualize a destruction dynamic set, for example, and you know, put in the forces, the operators, etc.? Do you do a pre-visual, or do you dive in straight away?
It really depends on what I'm doing. What's cool with destruction and TP is that with TP you can do amazing things with pretty simple setups. Compared to other software where you have sometimes to do a lot of EV constraint networks, things like that, in TP you can do really good looking stuff with simple setups. So most of the time I try to keep my setups simple, but of course sometimes it's more complicated, and I drew some shapes, and okay, it can take some time to figure out how things work, but I think TP is really straightforward. If you understand the logic once, then it's okay, you can do almost what you want.
At this point, Paul, I'm going to give viewers a quick browse of what are some of our latest features in TP 6.4 and 6.3. And Paul, which TP6 operators would you say are the most useful in your effects work?
A lot of things are easier to do, and for me, TP6 has really new, great new features, and the soft bodies, the liquid solver, it's really nice. But for me, the Alembic export and TPC are even more cool, because that's really makes my life easier every day, because every day I need to do caches, every day I export to Alembic. And, but not every day I do a liquid sim. So the new version of TP is really cool. Has really a lot of new cool new features for that.
Now we come to the juiciest part of this interview, and what everyone has been waiting for, and that's the effects we work for Ubisoft for Honor game cinematics, and how you, Paul, and your team was involved.
So yeah, I did two destruction shots for this trailer, and basically we were only three guys walking on the destructions. Alessandro Nardini, and he's done a really awesome job on this trailer. It was really cool to work with Alessandro, and I learned a lot from his experience. He's a really great FX artist. And there were also two Tufik Mekbel, who did some really cool smaller destruction elements, like for the scene inside the castle and things like that. It was really cool, but we were only three guys working on the destructions in 9 weeks of production for the VFX, and no overtime. You know, it was kind of hard work, but the good side of it. We learned a lot from each other. It was a really cool experience. So about my destruction workflow, what I like to do when it's possible, I like to start with a really low-res simulation. This way it's really fast to simulate. You can have a great feedback, you know, showing it to the director or the client. And you have a lot of control over the global motion of the simulation. And once everyone is happy with the low-res sim, it's pretty easy to add details on the edges and do other simulation passes. So what I did for the destructions on for Ono, like I exported the low-resolution pass and I separated it in something like 15 chunks of geometry, and this way it was easy to add extra details on the edges using a volume breaker and run the different chunks on the network independently. So yeah, it was really pretty straightforward. And what's cool is that if you have a look at the final result and at the low resolution pass, you can really see the global motion is the same.
Yes, and for this destruction, is it all TP or you use a combination of software?
All the destruction were done on TP. Because since we are a 3ds Max company, you know, Max guys always do very specific 3ds Max things, like using material IDs or map channels, things. And if you try to export it to other software like Maya or Houdini, it's not really easy to bring it back to 3ds Max. And what's really cool with TP is that if you work in a inside of Max, you will keep everything. You will keep the shaders, you will keep the material IDs, the map channels, and in game trailers, we don't have a lot of time to set up things, and we just want to have nice results, to be fast, and that's why with TP it's perfect. I mean, I get the models from the modeling guys inside of Max. I do the destruction, I keep all the shaders and things like that, everything works. I don't lose my time on the exports, you know. It's like it's easier if you are based on 3ds Max. It's really, really easier to use TP for those kind of things. And we used FumaFX, Flex FD, and Pyro Houdini for the smoke, and we also used Houdini for the water sim. And it was really cool because the new TP Alembic exports helped us a lot to export the destruction to Houdini.
We will now showcase Paul Parneix demo reel, which includes some really amazing TP breakdown on the Forerunner cinematic effects, and Paul will tell us something about, you know, his favorite thinking particle operators as well.
Yeah, I think my favorite operator in TP is definitely it's shape collision, because for me it's like magic, you know. when you look at the shape collision thing, it looks so, you feel the structure, it's the friction is really unique. And for me, shape collision is what made me fell in love with TP. And I'm still impressed today by every time I run a shape collision team. It's pretty cool. Now, I think more generally speaking, TP operators are really, really nice because you can, you have a lot of out of the box operators that can do great things and make your life easier. Like, for example, you have the P attach, which is in a lot of other software, you need to deal with metrics and quaternions to just attach a particle to a surface. And in TP, you have the P attach, and it's really easier to do this kind of thing. I also really love the egg timer node.
Right.
That's fun because I didn't know it before, and Alessandro showed it to me on For Honor, and since that day, I'm using it all the time.
Paul, what other Ubisoft game effects have you done? Can you show us a few more?
Yeah, at Image-Ubisoft, we've done many game trailers. For example, we did two trailers for the Crew game by Ubisoft, and I used the TP to create some complex tools for Funafix using camera projection techniques. We also worked on the Division trailer, where I did some fire sims using Funafix and Phonix FD, and I used TP as a particle source and to do some rigid body sim. And we also did the trailer for Sherlock Holmes game, where I did some rigid bodies using TP. And we also worked on some ads. For example, I worked on an ad for Peugeot, and I did big explosions on the frozen lake. And I used TP to create the particle source for the explosions. And I also used TP to do the snow blast at the base of the explosion using shape collision, volume breaker. It was pretty easy to set up. We also did an ad for a World of Tanks game where I worked with Omar Meradi, and he used TP to create the city reveal, and I used TP to do the world destruction on his shot. It was pretty cool. And we also did an ad for Michelin with big titans walking in a city, and I used TP to create some snow drifting on the ice titan, and to create the particles for the Funafix scene.
Can you tell us what inspires you most as an artist?
As a VFX artist, I focus on natural phenomena, it's pretty easy to form the inspiration. And I can remember even when I was doing physics at the university, I was in love with fluid dynamics, and I'm still really impressed by, oh, you know, simply sometimes I just look at my beer and I can stay 2 minutes watching the bubbles and thinking about the math behind that, and it's just like, yeah. It's amazing. So that's it's not hard for a VFX artist to find the inspiration. I think I'm just really impressed by the physics, and it's pretty fun to try to mimic it using computer graphics. But yeah, I'm just impressed by the fluid dynamics physics. I'm really, if I to keep talking about work as a person, I'm really inspired by guys. I know a lot of guys working in the industry that are older than me, and these guys are sharing a lot on the internet, and they're really smart to do this, because when they started back in the time, it wasn't that easy to learn things, and now we have a lot of resources to learn. If you want to start to learn software, it's so easy today, and maybe 20 years ago it wasn't that easy, and they used to learn more on production. And I have a lot of respect for those guys sharing their skill. If you want to learn TP, you have the Joe Scar course available for free on Vimeo, and this is really, really neat. If you want to learn TP, it's the best course you can find, in my opinion.
Those of you who are interested in Joe Scar's free TP videos, please email Cebas. Paul, we understand that you're also starting some online training in Paris. Can you tell us more about that? Thank you.
I'm doing, for now, I'm just doing it on the side. I teach Maya particles and Maya fluids for now. And I would really like to teach TP in Paris, but I don't know a school using TP yet. That would be amazing to have the ability to teach TP in Paris. But for now, yeah, I only teach Maya, a bit of Houdini also, and I would really love to teach TP in Paris. And I'm also preparing some video courses for TP, and I hope to really soon, as soon as possible.
So folks from France, please look out for Paul's video. And Paul, keep Cebas informed, because then we can support with special rates for your students in terms of our educational license for TP. And my next question, what is your wish for thinking particles in terms of more powerful features?
I really love the shape collision operator, and for me it's what makes TP so unique, because you can't find something similar in other software. So it would be amazing if you at Cebas you can keep improving this amazing solver. And but of course I also like all the new solvers. It's really nice to have all these different solver unified, and one can they can interact with each other. It's pretty cool. Now there are some operators that would be nice to have. Like I read the Joscar interview last week, and he talked about the snapshot AB operator, and for me it would be really nice to have this snapshot AB to be able to make chunks of particles when you do a volume breaker. You will be able to do clusters to avoid the Voronoi look of the standard volume breaker fracture. And for me, shape collision is just very unique. So if it can be faster, always faster, it would be really nice. But yeah. Yeah, you've done a really nice job on the thinking particle.
Paul, we will pass this on to our development team. And are you able to tell us a little bit about your up and coming projects?
Not really able to talk about the current project I'm working on these days, but I can just tell that there will be a lot of TV stuff in there. And that I'm using the new fluid solver to do some kind of thing. That's the only thing I can tell, I think. So.
Oh, you love the fluid solver. Anything else you'd like to add to this interview?
I just want to thank the whole Unity Image team for the amazing work they did on the trailer. On the interview, it can be really amazing, because it was really fun to work on this project. We learned a lot from each other. And thanks to the whole Unity Image crew, it was very nice. And thanks a lot to the Cebas guys and TP developers. I have a lot of respect for developers, software developers. As you said, I know a bit of code, but developers do the real magic, and then we just use the software to do the job. So yeah.
Yes. Our job. So thank you very much, Paul, for taking part in this interview.